Hi everyone and welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going to be going over the origin, insertion and action of the biceps brachii muscle. So here we can see the biceps brachii muscle and you can see the long head right here, and a good way to remember which side the long head is that it's the most lateral side. So alpha lateral, alpha long. And then the short head is closest to the stomach here, so S for short, S for stomach. So if you can remember the two of them, that's going to help you remember which side these two heads are. So because the biceps brachii muscle has two heads, it's also going to have two origins. So we've got this area right here, you can see this sort of sticking out bone. That's the coracoid process, so the scapula. And on the end of the coracoid process, you're going to have the origin of the short head of the biceps brachii muscle. And this short head's going to blend together partially with the coracobrachialis's origin as well. So let's move on to the long head. And the long head's going to come up here where my mouse is moving. And there's going to be a sort of indentation, like a recess, kind of going down this area here. And that's the bicipital groove. And that's where the long head of the biceps brachii tendon is going to move up through. And then it's going to come over the top here and it's going to originate here on the supraglenoid tubercle of the scapula. So you can see the glenoid cavity right here, and that's going to be superior to that. So it's going to be around where my mouse is here, just on the top of the glenoid cavity, just on the supraglenoid tubercle of the scapula. So moving on to the insertion of the biceps brachii muscle, you can see this bump right here, and that bump is where the two heads of the biceps brachii are going to come together and form a common tendon, and that bump's called the radial tuberosity. The radial tuberosity is obviously on the radius. Right next to it, you've got the ulna, and just superior, we've got the humerus. So lastly, you can see here, highlighted in blue, something called the bicipital aponeurosis. And depending on what book you read or who you talk to, this is considered by some to be a second insertion of the biceps brachii muscle. Now, traditionally, insertions connect muscles to bone. In this case, it's going to be connecting the muscle to the deep forearm fascia. It's going to be just medial to the insertion which we saw before. So, you know, we got laterally to this aponeurosis, we have that radial tuberosity where the two heads of the biceps brachii muscle are gonna come together and connect onto. So just medial to that, you got your bicipital aponeurosis. The purpose of the bicipital aponeurosis is thought to reinforce something called the cubital fossa. So the cubital fossa, you have like a little triangular shape right here, and that's where the brachial artery and the median nerve are going to run through, and that bicipital aponeurosis kind of comes over the top of them, and it's thought to provide protection to them. So we're back here again with the skeletal model, and you can see the origin of the short head of the biceps brachii here in red on the coracoid process. And the long head's gonna come up through the bicipital groove and connect right here on the supraglenoid tubercle of the scapula. Then it's gonna come down here and insert on the radial tuberosity. And the two heads are gonna combine together into one to insert here. But we've also got the bicipital aponeurosis, which you can't really see here as well. Well, we can't see it all. But that's gonna connect into the deep fascia of the forearm muscles rather than onto the bone. So it's connecting over these two joints. So the actions are going to be flexion of the elbow, because obviously it's crossing over the elbow joint. It's crossing over the shoulder joint as well. So we're going to have flexion of the shoulder joint too. Now, this is what most textbooks are going to say. There's just flexion of the shoulder joint, but most of the current research on this muscle is showing that it plays more of a dynamic stability role rather than directly flexing the shoulder. Obviously, if you've got a test or something, you're probably going to want to just put flexion in the shoulder there for simplicity's sake. That's what most of your textbooks are going to say. But just bear in mind, it's likely more of a dynamic stability role that it's playing rather than direct flexion. So finally, we got the last action. I can't really do it on this guy. He's not too flexible. But luckily, I'm a bit more flexible than him. So we got my forearm here in a pronated position. And if I'm to turn it over, so it's facing up, it's going to be supinated. So we got supination of the forearm, which is the final action of the biceps brachii muscle. And you can do this yourself. And as you turn it over, you can kind of feel your biceps flexing a little bit as it's supinating that forearm. So that covers the origin, the action, and the insertion, the biceps brachii. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, you know which buttons to press, and I'll see you all next time.